Hello, Cheetah fans, and welcome to yet another smashing episode of Cheetah Chase. In this month's show, we sit down with Coach Franco as he analyzes our Guinness Pro 14 season. We join players and management at the annual NAMPO Festival in Bothaville. Eager rugby and netball players from all around the Free State gather for the 2019 edition of the Cheetah Cub Day, and we attend the traditional jersey handover ceremony prior to the 2019 Craven Week tournament. After the conclusion of the 2018-19 Guinness Pro 14, we sat down with Coach Franco as he recalls the highs and lows of the season past and looks ahead to our upcoming Curry Cup campaign.
Well, first of all, I think it was a very special season. I think I've been involved with the Cheetahs now for a couple of years and a lot of seasons, and it was a very special one in the sense that it was a new group of guys with some of the previous experience guys already involved, you know. So to get the balance right from the start was quite difficult because you didn't want to frustrate the guys that's been with us for a certain period, and at the same time you must introduce a lot of new things to players that was in the different rugby programs. So the challenge started in the bit of a small pre-season that we had just before the Curry Cup started last year. I think very important was there were so many players that hasn't played in our environment, so in the first couple of games of the Curry Cup, we had to first understand what they're about. Because of the short pre-season or the season before we started, it was difficult to really know how well would JP Depree, for example, adapt, Tian Skuman, how would he will adapt, is Lufusje at 10 or 15, guys like Walt Steenkamp that's up to then only played Varsity Cup rugby. So there was a lot of guys, and at the same time you have Tian Meyer and Sean Venter and Charles Marais and Oaks and all those guys has already been in the system. So to start the building from there on was quite a challenge. But in saying that, the players, all credit to them and to the coaching staff, they all adapted nicely and they worked really hard, and there was consistent growth during the season. If one goes back from where we started off against Munster right in the beginning, there was the first time we went across to Limerick for most of the players, and the ball in play was more than 40 minutes, and we lost Oupa in the first 40 minutes of the competition to a knee injury. So immediately a little bit unsettled. We played really well. And then the trend was in the first couple of games, first three games, that we leaked a lot of tries towards the end of the game, and we paid dearly for that. And sometimes that scoreline didn't really affect the work that we've done. And from then on, I mean, we came back here, we played Ulster and we drew. Unfortunately, because I think that game was won in the 79th minute and they scored after the Luther went, which was disappointing in the end. But that was a game changer for us. It was a season changer for us. From then on, we really started being competitive every week. We toured to Cardiff and then to Edinburgh just straight after that, and it was, for me personally, very satisfying. We led in both games until the 73rd minute, and then just managed not to get across the line, which is a common trend from the side that builds and gets better. We came back and we had some very good performances at home. Unfortunately, fell short once or twice. I think a memorable win against Cardiff at home was the first one that we really got across the line. And if one looks at the whole season, you know, you look back and you see statistically how we improved and how much the guys got better. That was really, in that period up to Christmas, a very rewarding feeling. But we realised that after Christmas, a lot of the building blocks will be in place. So a lot of people would wonder, why do we always say we're building? It's not always teaching somebody else new things. It's also unteaching and getting rid of old habits that basically takes most of the time. And I felt after the December break, we came into a four-win winning streak, where I felt that there was a lot of the work done previous in the seasons we started seeing. It was always going to be a tough tour. I think there was a lot of expectation. A little bit of a disappointment for me was the game against Connacht, where we basically had them up against the ropes until the last minute. We outplayed them, outscored them, try-wise, and then unfortunately fell short. Poor start against the Scarlets in the first 20 minutes, but we managed to drag that back and won the last 60 minutes of the game, basically 25-14, which was an impressive comeback and some character that was shown. And you know, character is something that you can't coach, the team has to develop it, and that we saw. We then had a tough game against Leinster where I was really proud, especially around the adaption and the way we played, to kick the ball 47 times in that game, which would be a season record for us. But we had to, these conditions at that stage, you know, didn't allow us. And I think that's one of the big learnings this year is South African teams, and especially Cheetahs, had to learn how to win without the ball. We tended to hang onto the ball and try to score tries. And these the very well-organized European defense systems sometimes pressure you into errors. And once you start making those errors, they pounce on that and they use that in their favor to convert it in points. And I think that was one of the main learnings, is that we sometimes have to kick the ball to the opposition, ask them to make the play, force them into errors, change the turnover in your favor and try and score points. And I think that's what we learned from there. We really applied that well, especially in the second half against Glasgow. And then we came back home, unfortunate to lose against Auspice after a bit of a two-week break. I think we submitted to a lot of pressure and we allowed them to score 3 turnover tries, which was where they were better than us. It's just where we made errors. And then we finished off really well against the Dragons and the Kings. And you know, and looking back, we faced teams this season with an average age of 27. Our average age in 2018 was 23, and then fortunately there was a new year and it became 24. Main lessons this year, I think that we can take forward, is first of all that we have the ability to adapt our game at home. We must still have that flair and that ability to excite everybody, and we are really, really proud of the 80 tries that we scored in the season. I honestly believe that the main success story for me, I felt we developed that ability again. We didn't. In the first 3 games, there was 2 games where we didn't score a try, and we ended up scoring the 4th most tries in the competition. And there was teams that we, of some of the games that we didn't score tries. I think from our coaching perspective, we look back at the statistics, you know, I think our line-out functioned really well, scrum functioned really well. Like I said, with the attack, we did really well. I think we developed a defensive mindset as well. Obviously, your defense must be backed up by physical ability, and I think that's where we lacked in the beginning. We weren't physical enough for reasons. A lot of the new guys coming into our system, and also just physically being dominated by older players and more experienced players. And more we became competitive physically, the better we did. Be that maul time, scrum time, and obviously defensively, we started leaking less points towards the end. And I think that was very important for us. But unfortunately, with the 80 tries that we scored, we leaked too much tries during the season, and especially at vital time. So once we've understood the game management, how we're going to play, where we want to play on the field, which is necessary and different from what usually in South African and Super Rugby, the ask is different. We had to learn that. We had to know that the execution of our set piece must be very, very well. And then obviously that ability to win without the ball was our main learnings this far. And I believe that some of these guys learned the skills now that we can't wait to apply in the Curry Cup, and we can't wait to play against South African teams with the experience gained from that side. So the pro rugby is definitely going to have an influence also on South African rugby if we get it right in the Curry Cup. And we're all really looking forward to the Curry Cup. I think the whole Cheetah family is excited about it. We haven't played with our strongest available team in the competition for the last 2 years, and for us, it's going to be really important, you know, to measure ourselves against other teams in South Africa. We're excited. We hope that everybody would come and watch the Curry Cup games, because it still remains the flagship competition of South African rugby. I know that a lot of people would feel that in the years have declined a little bit, but I still believe it's to carry the honours of the Curry Cup in South African rugby plays an important role in the development of players. It also becomes a bit of an invitation to younger players to come and join the different franchises, and for us, it's really important then to really look forward to a very good Curry Cup campaign. The reasons we are excited about it, I think this is going to be a main ingredient in the last building blocks of the current Pro14 team. It will be the next step after the experience gained in Pro14, and to be as competitive as possible in the next Pro14. So in saying that though, it's going to be all about being significant, but also a bit we can also concentrate on winning, and that is an ingredient that I think we need now amongst our players to make us believe in even bigger things. So this year is going to be, or this Curry Cup is going to be special in the sense that we're going to have a bit of a pre-season before that. We're going to have the ability to sharpen up and really be well prepared for it, and then give our best team an opportunity to play in it. And in saying that, I don't want to create expectation that is not necessarily there. From experience, I've learned that our team feels that the expectation is too big. They tend to make mistakes, and because we're an eye care team, sometimes that influences the development of the team. So yeah, we're very excited about it. Very excited to play in the Curry Cup this year with our best team, but we're going to still see that as a next stepping stone into becoming the competitive side in Pro14 that we need to be.
Free State Rugby has always been a rich breeding ground for not only players, but coaches too, with the likes of Rossi Erasmus, Neil Powell and Jesse Pinar all elevating their careers at the Union. Now comes the time for Franco Smith to make the step up to international level.
Yeah, today was a very important date for the Cheetahs company. We have announced that we will release Franco to coach the international side of Italy as from January 2020, and that we will soon appoint a new head coach to take the Pro14 and then year after Curry Cup. Franco will, however, stay on as Curry Cup coach for this campaign, and after that he will stay on as director of rugby to look at contracting, training of coaches and other roles, but not involved with the coaching of Pro14. Well, first of all, we'll advertise internally through SARU on our website so that everybody that's interested can apply. Then the applications will go to a panel of role players, knowledgeable people, that will sift through it and then decide on the top five or so. And then interviews of the five, and eventually two or three presentations at the end of the day, and then appoint a head coach. And before the end of May, we want the applications in. And during June, we'll have all the interviews and activities. And by the end of June, we need to appoint the head coach. So before the start of the Curry Cup, everybody must know what's going to happen, and so that there's stability and continuation and calmness in our fold.
Good morning to the Cheetah fans. We're on our way to NAMPO.
Thank you, Buan. Yes, the annual adventure to Bothaville has become tradition for the Toyota Cheetahs, coaches and management. This year, a large contingent of players drove down for the festival and were warmly welcomed, as always, by Grain SA.
Baie welkom hier by die 53ste NAMPO, Gran SA NAMPO. Ons wil speciaal vir die Toyota Vrystaat Cheetahs baie welkom hier by NAMPO. Dankie dat ons kan assosieer met julle. Ek dink vir die hele landbougemeenskap, ons weet die Vrystaat is die middelpunt van die graanproduksie van Suid-Afrika. So dis lekker om julle hier te hê. Ons sien uit om al die produsente van reg oor die land hier by mekaar te kry waar ons die nuutste tegnologie by mekaar het op een plek. Dit is soos een groot reunie elke jaar hierso. En dis net lekker om almal hier te hê. En dankie dat die Toyota Vrystaat Cheetahs vandag hier is. Dit is 'n baie groot organisasie. Dit is meer as 700 uitstallers. Die belangrikste is die nuutste tegnologie is alles op een plek. 'N Boer hoef nie nou van een stad na ander stad na een maatskappy na ander maatskappy terrein nie. Alles is hier op een terrein. Van saad tot die nuutste landbouchemie, tot die nuutste trekkers, of dit nou hernubare energie is, sonkrag, waterpompe, enigiets waaraan jy kan dink, is alles hier by mekaar. Dit is definitief 'n platform vir ouens om hulle nuutste goed op die mark hier na NAMPO toe te bring. Die voete wat hier deurkom is 70,000-80,000 mense plus. So ek dink die voete wat jy hierso het, gaan jy op geen ander plek kry.
Toyota Cheetah fans, another great day at NAMPO with Toyota South Africa. I'm standing with one of the Toyota Hiluxes, and you'll see the branding here of Toyota Gazoo Racing. Now, Toyota South Africa, also the sponsors of Nasser Al Attiyah, who won this year's Dakar Racing. Toyota South Africa, thank you very much for being associated with the Toyota Cheetahs, and very proud to be also part of the Toyota Gazoo Racing.
Also, vandag hier so by NAMPO woensdag en ons is toch voor die spelers en kom kijken een beetje bij die Toyota stalletje. Dit is voor ons zo lekker om geassocieerd te zijn met een great brand als Toyota. Dus kom kijken een beetje hoe verkopen vandaag een paar karren bij NAMPO en adverteren een beetje alle wonderlijke producten. Dus het is voor ons lekker om hier te wees en baie lekker om geassocieerd te zijn met hulle en het is een lekker dag hier op NAMPO.
Mensen vragen mij gewoonlijk wat is mijn lengte. Maar moet niet worry oor mijn lengte nie. Die Land Cruiser zal je definitief pas.
Yes, lengte is niet een issue nie. Soos julle kan sien, die Land Cruiser is wel allemaal gepast.
We staan hier bij OVK, hier zo bij NAMPO Park. En hulle het 'n baaldraal competitie, is wolbale wat jy moet vir 40 meter draai. Jy moet daar om die onderste vlag gaan en terugkom. En ja, vir die skoolkinders, denk ek, is het 40 of 60 kilo's. En vir die groot mense is het nou 120 kilo's. En dan wil nou kyk wie hier die beste tyd. So ja, interessante idee wat ek denk nie baie mense van weet nie.
We, the Marlow High School from Carrick, we challenged the Toyota Free State Cheetahs team to a wool baling competition, and as you can see, we've set the standards very high for them.
Ja, hij is toch altijd redelijke gewichtjes, maar gekost vast bij de les lijkt. En het is lekker sportie bij NAMPO dag, zo so, ja, denk die mensen genieten nogal bij.
Well, Cheetah fans, that's us here at NAMPO Park. Till next year, we'll see you here again.
Smiles, excitement and all-round fun was once again the theme as youngsters from all around the province gathered at Jim Fushia Primary for the much-anticipated 2019 Cheetah Cub Day.
Goeiemôre en baie welkom by die Cheetah Welpie Dag. Saterdagoggend lekker koel hier in Bloemfontein. Ons het 'n paar spanne wat vanoggend deelneem. Ek dink as ons reg onthou, is dit amper oor die 30 rugby spanne en seker naas vir my ook dieselfde netball spannetjies. Saam met my het ek vir Jewan. Jewan, is jy reg vir die dag?
Ja.
Gaan jy wen?
Ja.
Baie mooi dag wat voor lê hierso. Ons sal julle op hoogte hou.
Today is lots of children coming from different schools. We have people from Klokkelaan, Fixburg, Bloemfontein. So yeah, it's a really nice day. Everyone is playing a bit Baligi rugby. And yeah, so we're gonna enjoy it. All of them have received training. We have different schools in different areas. We are working for RSDA, Rugby Skills and Development. We're encouraging the youngsters to play rugby from their young age and then develop until they either get Springbok colors or provincial colors. And that is the goal in the end. And yeah, we enjoy it very much. And then the satisfaction you get from one guy starting from nothing and then ending up tackling the biggest guy in the whole group and he's the smallest, that just makes my day.
We are here to develop the girls to their full potential. So we're working with girls from the age of 4 right up to high school if they want to develop. And we actually do it for the school so that it's much easier for the schools so that they don't struggle with the girls with their ball skills and with their ball skills.
I'm here today to assist them with the NSD. It's something that's new to the Free State and really, really we need this because I am involved with the primary schools and some of the high schools. But on primary level and even the high schools, if they are not a netball school, there isn't any skills. So this is the best thing that can ever happen to Free State as a province. And if we can, we would like to broaden it to the other districts as well, not only Mangaung Metro. Yeah, this is my first time today here, so I'm still learning, but it's all about the skills and it's about fun. And what we need as a coach, I want them to learn to play netball here and here. So that is what they will learn here.
This is a lovely day in Bloemfontein. We're here at Jim Fushier Primary School supporting Biliki Rugby. There's about 40 teams here, so all the parents are coming for support. Very enjoyable, all sitting in their campus seats and watching all the young talent. I can still remember when I was young, playing in the morning like this, 8 o'clock in the winter morning, having cold feet on these fields. Yeah, just enjoying it. And that is what rugby is about. for children like this enjoying a day like today.
Ag, is baie lekker om te hê, maar ek dink dit gaan also die geniet. Ek dink ons moet nie te ernstig wees hier nie. Die mannetjies moet nie net gaan oor die wen nie. En hulle moet leer dat gaan oor die gees en dat dit gaan lekker wees om sommer net deel te neem.
Ja, nee, is lekker rugby vandag. Ons sien uit na die kinders, hoe hulle vorder en ja, ek sien hulle is ook baie bly om hier kan speel vandag.
It is very important because they are getting exposed at young age and I'm sure the love of it and the passion will just be built up and then he can excel when he grows up. Because that is the first sport that I saw that I was a bit skeptic about it because of the tackling and everything. But now that he's been exposed at a young age, I think he's going to do great. And I'm excited and I'm proud of him doing what he's doing now. It's unbelievable actually to see him doing what he's doing now. And I would like also to thank the opportunity that he has gotten to be in a tournament at his young age at Grade R. So I'm just seeing the sky's the limit for him.
Hierdie mannetjies oefen heel jaar net vir hierdie Cheetah dag, want dis waar ons kan tackle en nie tags hoef te speel nie. So ons is baie opgewonde. Kan ek gou 1 2 3 klokkies hoor? 1 2 3. Dankie julle.
Rugby!
Earlier this year, Toyota SA extended their title sponsorship with the Bloemfontein franchise by another 3 years. Now, with the Curry Cup around the corner, the players and management received their brand new fleet of vehicles alongside associate sponsor Cartrack.
We're going to do their fleet. We fitted the FM Plus unit with driver ID tags. So for business and private use, see where the place is going for SARS purposes and for recovery as well. So if a car vehicle, one of the vehicles gets stolen, it's got full recovery and it's in Cartrack's hands to get the car back.
Toyota fans, today we're very fortunate to hand out a new fleet of vehicles thanks to our friends and sponsors at Toyota South Africa, to our players and management. Obviously it's a massive privilege to drive these vehicles, you know, to be associated with Toyota gives us that edge and it makes us a strong team on the field. The players are very, very grateful for these vehicles and thanks to Toyota South Africa for not only being our sponsor, but also our supporter and our friend.
On behalf of the Toyota Cheetahs, the players, the management, we would like to thank Toyota South Africa on their wonderful sponsorship and them helping us going forward, you know, always keeping us on the road, making sure that we're safe and we get to our destination in one piece. So, yeah, we'd really like to thank you and yeah, we'll take care of the cars.
Prior to the 2019 edition of the annual Craven Week tournament, we attended the traditional jersey handover ceremony for all the youth teams that will represent the province in the rigorous tournament, which will be hosted in Bloemfontein.
Tonight we are having our annual kit handover function for the youth teams for the High Schools Association. The teams that will be getting the kit tonight is the under 16 Grand Combo team, the Elson Week team, that's your learners with special education needs, the Under 18 Academy Week team, and the Under 18 Craven Week team. And three of the teams will be participating in Bloemfontein. The Elson Week is starting this weekend on Sunday, and they will be playing next week during the week. And in the very first week of July, we'll have the Craven Week and the Academy here in Bloemfontein at Grey College.
Craven Week 2019 is going to be a big one. It's a huge one, first of all, being at Grey College. So all the teams will come out as all the fighting power to play against us. So we're only focusing on day one. That's the Sharks, the main game. We're taking game by game, day by day. So we're not looking at a second round or finals or whatever, or the last day. We're focusing mainly on the Sharks. This coming Saturday, we're playing against the Bulls, our last practice match. That's also going to test us. And after this weekend, we can see where we are in our preparation. So this year, we've got a point to prove, but still, we're focusing on our game and what we want to bring to the Craven side. So yeah, day by day, that's our main focus.
I don't think you should concentrate on the results. You should concentrate on your game and enjoy it, because it's coming. If some of us lost one. So I just think we should go out there, enjoy it, live ourselves out and play the game we love and remember why we play it.
Well, it's very exciting. I think you must wait until the official announcement is made. But from where I heard from our selectors, we've got a very strong team. Remember, we're playing at home, so we'll be under pressure from other provinces, so we'll expect the boys to do what is good in terms of winning the Craven Week Championship here in our own home soil.
That's all for this month. For more information on all things Cheetah, log on to our website at www.fscheetah.co.za, or you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram for all the latest happenings, photos and uploads. So until next month, keep supporting and, as always, freestyle! Cheetah, cheetah, alle sind die Kunde, sei Cheetah.